In Los Angeles, California, the Academy of Motion Picture Arts and Sciences invites you to the 78th Annual Academy Awards.
Welcome, everybody, to our showcase, the night at the Oscars. Welcome, welcome. Good to have everybody.
All right. Yeah, welcome, everybody. We have quite a show for you today, and we're here in Hollywood on the red carpet. We have a lot of artists that are arriving now to be on the showcase. We're actually from Gaithersburg Group Fest, the good morning, good afternoon, and good night broadcast.
And we'd like to welcome our special co-host, Marc Gallagher. So we're so grateful that he's here.
There he is.
How you doing, Marc? As part of the can't hear you.
I can't hear you for some reason.
There we go. It is my absolute pleasure to be here. No, you're fine. We had our mic down. Sorry. These technical things, I tell you.
Oh, I right. say.
Thank you for being our co-host today, Marc.
So I see this handsome fellow walking down the aisle here. I think he's from the Czech Republic. Oh, who is this guy?
We've got a fantastic lineup as part of this Oscar celebration. We've got Vlastimil Prochaska from the Czech Republic. I believe he's from Unitetsa near Prague. We've also got some wonderful artists. Looking down the red carpet now, there's absolutely... we've got Calico, who looks absolutely gorgeous today. We've got some dazzlers in the form of Vlastimil, looking very chic. And we've also got some great performances from... further people, Matthew Quilliam, I think, is on board. We've also got Choan Galvez, as looking like a very exciting night indeed.
Well, thank you so much, Marc. Unfortunately, I don't think Matthew Quilliam's going to be performing. He's just in the audience. But it is great to see him today. And he's looking really spiffy in his outfit. We do have a young lady named Wendy Matthews. She's going to perform today. And we're happy about that. See, who else we got? Oh, we have this young lady from Brazil. You know anything about her, Marc? Her name is Aline Kelly.
Aline Kelly, I do believe. Yes, from what I've heard, Aline Kelly, she's looking wonderful today. She's a very exciting artist from Brazil. Looking forward very much to hearing from her.
Yes. And we have another artist from the United States. We only have two from the United States. Can you believe that? But he hasn't been on our show for a while. He goes by the name of Ukester Brown. The real name is David Reminger. So he's coming to us. He came all the way to the show from Minnesota. So, Marc, it's going to be a great show today. And so let's go ahead and introduce our first artist.
Our first artist today is one that I'm very excited about. I've met him on a couple of occasions in various parts of Europe. I've met him in Berlin. I've met him also in, as I mentioned, Unitetsa in near Prague in Czech Republic. It is my pleasure to welcome Vlastimil Prochaska onto the virtual stage.
Okay, I hope you hear me already. Aloha! The first song was from Indiana Jones, from George Lucas's movies, so I hope you recognized it. And Second song is, I think, a Hawaiian folk song, because the name is Aloha Dali. Oh, sorry, my mistake. That's not Aloha Dali. It's Hello Dali. So probably it's not a Hawaiian song, but who cares? Mahalo, that was Hello Dali, and next song is Love Song. I would like to sing this song for all women in audience, and especially for that woman. Whenever you prepare some intro to Love Song, never use real names, because it can go to some mistakes or misunderstandings. And you can use the intro again and again for all women in your life, especially in this song, which is about love for a spaceship called Apollo. Fly me to the moon and let me play among the stars. Let me see what spring is like on Jupiter and Mars. In other words, hold my hand. In other words, darling, kiss me. Fill my heart with song and let me sing forevermore. In other words, please be true. In other words, I love you. Forevermore, you are all I long for. and adore. In other words, please be home. In other words, in other words, I love you. Mahalo, that was my second song, and third song is again love song, and it's from Czechoslovakia. It was used in a movie Dark Blue World, and the composer is a very famous songwriter in Czechoslovakia, Jaroslav Ježek. The name of the song is Svita. Jaroslav Ježek worked before Second World War, and he escaped to United States before Hitler's coming to Prague. He's gone in New York in 1942. So his song Svita in my arrangement for Louji Ukulele. Thank you very much. I will introduce you my timekeeper. It's this nice bull terrier, and he just told me that it's time for the last song for my performance, and it will be On the Sunny Side of the Street from the Edit the Chin story with 4 nominations, even when here is already evening and it's dark outside. I think we can play this song. Thank you. Hello. That was end of my performance. I would like to thank to Kate, to Nani, to their academy for nominating me to this evening. I would like to thank to Marc Gallagher, to all my ukulele friends for support, to my family, to my wife for the support, to all luthiers in the world. Now I will tell you their names. Sorry, I got carried away. I have last duty in this evening, and it's introducing the next performer. When I was young, I spent almost all my childhood next to the borders between Czechoslovakia and Austria. And we couldn't go through this border because it was closed. My first visit of Austria was in 1990, and I found beautiful country and very nice people there. So I'm very glad that I can tell you that the next performers are two girls from Austria. They have beautiful voices, nice ukuleles, and their name is Calico. So here they are.
Thank you for
Thank
the introduction.
You. And cheers to you. Beautiful performance.
As you can see, we're perfectly prepared for
yes.
the Academy Awards today. We got dressed up really nicely. We don't get a chance often nowadays. And cheers to you all.
Yeah.
But
Thank
we
you.
Are not here to drink.
No,
we're here to perform. And the first song we want to perform for you is from the Academy Awards, the winner of 1979. It's actually from the Muppet movie. And Kermit performs it, Kermit the Frog. He performs it with a banjo, but we thought ukulele is much better.
Yes.
A few people tried themselves on this song. People like Gwen Stefani, The Carpenters, Willie Nelson, and the Dixie Chicks. We're going to add our performance to this list.
Why are there so many songs about rainbows? And what's on the other side? But only illusions, and rainbows have nothing to hide. So we've been told, and some choose to believe it. I know they're wrong, wait and see. Someday we'll find it, the rainbow connection, the lovers, the dreamers, and me. Who said that every wish would be heard and answered when wished on the morning star? Somebody thought of that, and someone believed him, and look what it the lovers, the dreamers, and me, all of us on the river.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much. So I have to change my ukulele.
The next song is from 1944, and it did win again. It's a winning song. It's performed by Bing Crosby. It's from the movie Going My Way. It's called Swinging on a Star. And there is a cute story to this. The composer is called Jimmy van Huysen. He went to dinner at Bing Crosby's, and one of the kids started to complain about having to go to school the next day. And apparently Bing Crosby himself said,
if you don't go to school, you might end up to be a mule.
And this is how the lyrics from the song actually were inspired.
Yeah, the songwriter thought that would make a lovely song. And now you're going to hear it. Brings us to our next song. The next song, unfortunately, wasn't a winner, but it was nominated for an Academy Award. It actually was written for a Marx Brothers film in 1935, but they didn't play it in the movie. And in 1951, Louis Armstrong performed it with different lyrics, but the sound was the same for the movie The Strip.
Yes, The Strip. The movie Strip. That the song that actually won in that year was called In the Cool, Cool, Cool of the Evening. We listened to that song. We didn't like it. For us, this song is the winner. It's A Kiss to Build a Dream On.
And it's a perfect example for how songs live on even when the movies are long forgotten.
Give me a kiss to build a dream on, and my imagination will thrive upon that kiss, sweetheart.
Thank you. Thank you so much. So for the last song we've chosen, I think quite a popular song at the moment. It's from the movie Once, an Irish independent romance, maybe, from 2007. It's of course features Glenn Hansard and Marketa Irglova. And she said about the song is about hope. And hope at the end of the day connects us no matter how different we are. And we think that is a perfect quote to end on. Here's for you, Falling Slowly. Thank you so much for having us.
Thank you.
We're gonna skip the whole thank you speech and give it right back to Mark, the co-host, Marc Gallagher. Thank you.
Thank you very much. It's such a lovely performance from Calico, as always. It's such a pleasure to listen to them. It's a lovely song, that Falling Slowly, from the film Once. We're going to hear such wonderful songs from many great films. And we're gonna continue hearing that all throughout today. However, for now, I wanted to give you a brief history on music in film. For me, when I was studying for my music production degree, I was looking at the dissertation, and I did the effects of studying how to sort of like construct professional wrestling entrance themes. And there was a bit of an overlap to that in music in film with respects to sort of building character, sort of creating setting. And I wanted to kind of just touch on like how that sort of came to be. As we might be aware, film and moving pictures started and developed in the late 1800s. Just moving pictures, they were sort of a relatively uneventful setting, such as to people boarding a train. However, once we started capturing and developing the technology for these films, we started making larger pictures, which were able to show in movie theaters like we see today. However, However, because we weren't able to synchronize audio with the film itself, what happened was during these sets, you'd have live performances. They'd be sometimes in the form of a piano player, sometimes in the form of like a full string quartet, and multiple showings of this film throughout the day, you'd get these live orchestra, this live music. But the best part is, these performances were completely improvised. They just saw what was happening on screen and they just started playing along. Over the courses of playing multiple times a day for these showings, you started gaining idea of the beats of what to sort of play when, you know, someone's falling down the stairs and you're playing piano, plunk, 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 plunk. And they'd start to developing from there. Occasionally there were some sort of like notes to fall off of. If there was any music written, it was often ripped off by a dead or very obscure composer. But I found that really interesting. This practice of having live music during the course of film showing, this continued when talkies were developed. However, musicals flooded the market for everything to just stop, and you'd have a score written, or you'd have music available, and you'd have these performers accompanying the singers that you were seeing on screen. I found that quite marvelous. With film and talkies, the first film to have synchronized speech with the film was The Jazz Singer, the first ever line being, "Wait a minute, you ain't heard nothing yet," which I thought is quite marvelous. The first animated picture inspired directly from The Jazz Singer to have synchronized audio from an animated perspective was the film Steamboat Willie. It's a Walt Disney feature. You might see it on Disney Plus. You might also notice it as the signature to a lot of their animated films. And as this sort of developed and grew, we started incorporating scoring more, using music as in a breaking out into song context. You sort of set the mood. This was initiated with 1933's King Kong, which is something, again, I've cited in my university research. It was the first one to have comprehensive scoring throughout. And this followed the classical scoring technique. You take a full orchestra and you'd have your parts working against setting the scene. And this developed a little bit more in the 30s as jazz grew in more prominence. Things like A Streetcar Named Desire really set the New Orleans musical setting through its use of jazz, through its use of instrumentation. And it really gave sort of an edge to not just the atmosphere that we're in, but also the characters showing a certain unease about it. Over the years and the decades, we've seen musical scoring develop. We've seen more electronic, more unorthodox things in films like The Terminator. And then we've seen a sort of a resurgence with John Williams going back to classical scoring, films such as Star Wars, Jurassic Park, having these iconic scores, along with the introduction of soundtracks, people bringing in songs, whether it be like from licensed music, to just sort of give a chance to sort of sell the music as a separate package to that of the film itself. We've seen things like evolve, and we've seen them come full circle, as I mentioned, with classical scoring, and it's so lovely to see these great works of art, these great pieces of music on display tonight. This has been lovely. I'm going to head off and I'm going to introduce the next artist. This wonderful lady from Connecticut has been doing some great work with the Educated Fleas, and now she's playing as herself. Please welcome to the stage Wendy Matthews.
Wendy, you have to unmute.
Okay, there I was chatting away. Thank you, Mark, for that interesting history. And I just wanted to thank the Academy for inviting me to participate in this wonderful event this evening or afternoon, depending on where you are. So I'm going to start with a song that was from the very first year when the songs became a category in the Academy Awards. That was 1934. So in 1934, that category was added to the Oscars. And this particular song was nominated for Best Song. It's from the movie Flying Down to Rio. The song's name is Carioca, And perhaps it's most notable because it introduced Fred and Ginger to the world. So this was the very first time they were ever seen together dancing on screen, and they danced to this song. Say, have you seen that carioca? It's not a foxtrot or a polka. It's got a little bit of new rhythm, a blue rhythm that sighs. It's got a meter that is tricky, a little wicked, wacky, wicky. When you dance it with a new love, there'll be true love in her eyes. You'll dream of the new carioca. Its theme is a kiss and a sigh. You'll dream of that new carioca. When music and lights are gone and we're saying goodbye. Two heads together, they say, are better than one. Two heads together, that's how the dance is begun. Two arms around you and lips that sigh. I am yours and you are mine, while the carioca carries you away. Mine, while the carioca till the break of day. And you are mine. You'll dream of that new carioca. Its theme is a kiss and a sigh. You'll dream of that new carioca. When music and lights are gone and we're saying goodbye. Now that you've seen the carioca, you'll never care to do a polka. Soon you'll realize the blue hula and bamboula are through. In the morning you'll discover you're just a carioca lover. When you dance it with a new love, there'll be true love just for you. You'll dream of the new carioca. Its theme is a kiss and a sigh. You'll dream of that new carioca. When music and lights are gone and we're saying goodbye. When music and lights are gone and we're saying goodbye. Thank you. I got distracted by a little noise there. I don't know what that was. It might be my buttons, my Academy Award-winning outfit. Okay, so my next song is actually from a movie that was released in 1936 called Rhythm on the Range. It was when cowboy movies were all the thing, right? So this particular song was sung by Bing Crosby in the movie. The song is called I'm an Old Cowhand, and it's a very early song by Johnny Mercer, who went on to be nominated for the Academy Award for Best Song 18 times. 18. However, this song was not nominated. I don't know why, because it's a great song, so I hope you enjoy it. I'm an old cowhand from the Rio Grande, but my legs ain't bowed and my cheeks ain't tanned. I'm a cowgirl who never saw a cow, never roped a steer, cause I don't know how. I sure ain't fixin' to start it now. Yippee-i-o-ki-yay, hey, yippee-i-o-ki-yay. I'm an old cowhand from the Rio Grande, and I learned to ride, for I learned to stand. I'm a rider
know every trail in the Lone Star State. I ride them all in my Ford V8. Yippee-i-o-ki-yay, hey. Yippee-i-o-ki-yay, I'm an Ocal hand from the Rio Grande, where the West is wild by the borderlands, where the buffalo roam around the zoo. The Indians will make you a rug or two, and the old bar X is just a barbecue. Yippee-i-o-ki-yay, hey. Yippee-i-o-ki-yay, I'm an old cowhand from the Rio Grande. And I come to town, or maybe the Gaithersburg Ukefest, just to hear the band. I know all the songs that the cowboys know about, the big corrals where the doggies go, cause I heard them all on the radio. Yippee-i-o-ki-yay, hey. Yippee-i-o-ki-yay. Yippee-i-o-ki-yay, hey. Yippee-i-o-ki-yay. That's a fun one. Okay, so the next one I'm going to do is a little bit more modern, not much, but a little bit. It was nominated for Best Song in a Movie in 1943. The movie that it was featured in was called Something to Shout About. Now, I'm not familiar with that movie. Maybe you are. However, the song is called You'd Be So Nice to Come Home To, and it was written by the one and only Cole Porter. It didn't win that year. I don't know why, but it's a wonderful song, and I hope you enjoy it. You'd be so nice to come home to. You'd be so nice by the fire, while the breeze on high sang a lullaby. You'd be all that I could desire, under stars chilled by the winter, under an August moon burning above. You'd be so nice, you'd be paradise to come home to and love. You'll be so nice to come home to. You'll be so nice by the fire, while that breeze on high sang a lullaby. You'd be all that I could desire, under stars chilled by the winter, under an August moon burning above. You'd be so nice, you'd be paradise to come home to and love. Thank you. Thank you so much. It's so nice to see some friendly faces out there. So my last song was actually written in 1934. However, it didn't appear in a film until 1955. when it was used for the theme to the movie Picnic. The song is called Moonglow, and the composer for the music for the film used the theme of Moonglow and then superimposed another little theme over the top of it. And that probably made Moonglow a much more famous song than it had been before. I think most people remember it from the film Picnic. So Picnic was nominated for 6 Academy Awards, including Best Picture. This particular song, of course, was not nominated because it was not an original song. But I think we should do it anyway because it's the Oscars. Okay. Moonglow. Must have been moon glow way up in the blue. It must have been moon glow that led me straight to you. I still hear you saying, dear one, hold me fast. And I start to praying, dear Lord, please let this last. We seem to float right through the air. Heavenly songs seem to come from everywhere. And now when there's moon glow way up in the blue, I'll always remember that moon glow gave me you. Ba-dum-ba-da, ba-da, ba-da, da, ba-ba-da, da, ba-ma-da. Ba-dum-ba-da, ba-da, ba-da, da, ba-ba-da, da, ba-ma-da. It must have been moon glow way up in the blue. It must have been moon glow that led me straight to you. I still hear you saying, dear one, hold me fast. And I start to praying, oh Lord, please let this last. We seem to float right through the air. Heavenly songs seem to come from everywhere. And now when there's moon glow way up in the blue, I'll always remember that moon glow gave me you. That moon glow gave me you. That moon glow gave me you. Thank you so much. Thank you, Nani and Keith. And of course, the Academy. Okay, so next up, we've already heard from him, but I think now we might even get to hear him play. The one, the only Marc Gallagher, who is known as a singer-songwriter, And he does a lot of originals, and if you look on YouTube, he's got lots of collaborations with other ukulele performers that are wonderful. His website says he plays songs you never knew you wanted to hear on the ukulele, and that he's always entertaining. So take it away, Mark.
Hello again. Let's just dive straight into it. Time to my chances. Like the distance down back on my happy, just a man and his will to survive. So many times it happens to us. You trade your passion for glory. Don't lose your grip on the dreams of the past. You must fight just to keep them alive. It's the eye of the tiger. It's the thrill of the fight. Rising up to the challenge of our rival. And the last no survivor stalks his prey in the night. And he's watching us all with the eye of the tiger. Face to face, out in the heat, hanging tough, staying hungry. They spread the odds when they take to the streets for the kill and the skill to survive. It's the eye of the tiger, it's the thrill of the fight, rising up to the challenge of our rival. The tiger. The eye of the tiger. Rising up straight to the top. Had the guts, got the glory. Went the distance, now I'm not going to stop. Just a man and his will to survive. It's the eye of the tiger, it's the thrill of the fight. Rising up to the challenge of our rival. And the last no survivor stalks his prey in the night. And he's watching this all with the eye of the tiger. The eye of the tiger. The eye of the tiger.
That was fun.
That was, of course, Eye of the Tiger by Survivor from Rocky 3. It won the Academy Award for Best Original Song. Up next, I'm going to do a song that's been featured in a few different films. You probably are most familiar with it from Matilda, although it did appear in the Academy Award-nominated film Ice Age. It was nominated for Best Animated Feature in 2003. It did lose out to Spirited Away, which is an incredible film, so I don't blame it. But this song is quite nostalgic. It's quite a positive one, an uplifting one. This is called Send Me On My Way by Rusted Root. Sounds a lot like this.
On my way. And I would like to reach out my hand. I'm gonna say you, I'm gonna tell you to run. Say it on you. So pick me up with golden hand. I may say you, I may tell you to run. But I say it on you. Well, I would like to hold my little hand. We will run and move, we will crawl, we will. I would like to hold. Run. The state of the young. So pick me up with golden hand. I may say you, I may tell you to run. What they say about the young? Well, I would like to hold my little hand. We will run and we will crawl, we will grow. I would like to hold my little hand. We will run and we can run. Send me on my way, send me on my way, send me on my way, send me on my way.
Very much. So much fun that. Oh, lovely. I think I have one more song left. I'll keep it a quick one. And this is from a film with such an amazing soundtrack. This is a little song from the Blues Brothers. My name is Marc Gallagher. Thank you very much for watching my set. You'll be seeing a lot more later of me as I sort of chat to you a little bit about Oscars, in particular, the statues.
Nice to see Keith dancing there. Look at him all. Baby, don't you want to go? Heidi, hey. Baby, don't you want to go? Back to the same old place. Sweet home, Chicago. Well, one of one is two. Sister two is eight. Come on, baby, don't you make me late, Heidi, hey. Baby, don't you want to go back to the same old place, sweet home, Chicago. Just give it a little solo a go. You know what I mean, Heidi, hey. Baby, don't you want to go back to the same old place, sweet home, Chicago. Look him on. Baby, don't you want to go? Look him on. Baby, don't you want to go back to the same old place, sweet home, Chicago.
Thanks very much. My name is Marc Gallagher. I hope you guys enjoy the rest of the show. Cheers. What I will say is, before I go, I'd love to introduce you to my next act. This is a lovely lady from Brazil, I believe. You've probably seen her all over Instagram or over Facebook. She is such a marvelous player, and I'm really excited to see her set. Please welcome to the virtual stage, Aline Kelly.
Hello, everyone. Can you hear me? It's nice and a pleasure to be here again. And Thanks for the invitation. Let's play. The first song is My Favorite Things from the movie The Sound of Music. The movie was nominated for 10 Academy Awards and won 5. I hope you enjoy it. And let's play. Best scoring of music adaptation for the movie The Sound of Music. Thanks. The next song, this song is my fresh arrangement from the movie Dirty Dancing, 1988. My sister asked me to play this song for her, and the Oscar for Best Music Original Song goes to I've Had the Time of My Life. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you, everyone. Now it's time to talk with Marc Gallagher again.
Hello, everyone. It's nice to see you guys again. I'm sure you're all sick of my face at this point. However, I wanted to kind of just shed a little spotlight on the Oscars themselves. We've spoken and we've got this lovely themed night at the Oscars, and we talk about the awards. But I want to kind of talk about the little statuettes themselves. You're all familiar with them. For over 90 years, the Oscar statuettes are a symbol of excellence. They're a symbol of the premier films in our industry. And I wanted to kind of look at the specifics of why we even have Oscars in the first place. You're all familiar with the design, the knight, on a little film reel. The film reel's got five spokes, which is representing the five different pillars of the Academy themselves: the actors, the writers, the directors, producers, and technicians. These have remained the five core principles of the Academy, even as the film industry has advanced and developed over the last 90 plus years. You're familiar, these statues are, they've gone through various sort of like combinations of metals before being plated with 24 karat gold. However, an interesting fact I found was that during the Second World War, there was a metal shortage, and for 3 years running, the statues given were just painted plaster, which I thought is quite the award to get. Obviously, once the steel industry kind of got back into back on its feet post the war, they were all sort of retroactively rewarded their, you know, nicer non-plaster based Oscar statues. As for the name, the Oscars, there are a couple of sort of like origin stories. The one you might be more familiar with is that of the Secretary Margaret Herrick. She saw this in the so these Oscars, they were brought in 1929, and she, a few years in, noticed and remarked that they reminded her of her uncle Oscar, and that sort of name stuck on because she was there. She said it in front of a couple of journalists who ended up reporting this sort of in, they started referring to it as the Oscar in terms of so-and-so won the Oscar around about the mid-30s or so. It was then Walt Disney. Walt Disney is quite famous in the fact of he won 22 different Oscars, which is absolutely mental. It's the most Oscars that any single person has ever won. And he was the first person in like the history to, it was in 1984, for his acceptance speech, he thanked the Academy for his Oscar. The other name that you might have recognized, or the other origin story with the Oscar name, came from Betty Davis. In 1941, she was the president of the Academy, or she was a president of the Academy, and she claimed that she named it from her husband, a band leader of the same name. But yeah, I think it's quite interesting, you know, the fact that we've got such it's such an iconic symbol of excellence, and I thought I'd just shed a little light on, you know, what it actually sense and how the name the Oscars even came to be. We're going to move on to some more live music now, and it's my pleasure to introduce the wonderful David, or you might also know him as Ukester Brown. Please give it up, David.
Hopefully I'm unmuted there. Can you hear me? Okay. Thanks again to Keith and Nani for the invitation to come and perform today. It's going to be another fun time for me to be here. I got just a couple songs for you today, and then I'll introduce you to the next performer. This song comes from a movie, relatively new movie, at least in my mind, from Sleepless in Seattle. And Harry Connick Jr. is the one who orchestrated this song called A Wink and a Smile. And here's my take on A Wink and a Smile. Remember the days of just keeping time, hanging around in sleepy towns forever, backwards for miles. Well, you can't have a dream and cut it to fit, but when I saw you, I knew we'd go together like a winking smile. That old jalopy by the railroad track,
We'll get a hip double dip tip toppy two seat bottleneck where you can rev her up. Don't go slow, it's only green lights and all rights. We go together like a wink and a smile. Such a simple song. Sing it again, the notes never end. This is where I belong. Just the sound of your voice, the light in your eyes. You're so far away from yesterday. Together, like a wink and a smile. We go together, like a wink and a smile. Thanks, everybody. This next song that I'm going to do, and this will be my last song tonight, is from the movie Royal Wedding. Fred Astaire and I'm going to goof on the actress's name. She's very, she should be more well known, and that's why I can't remember her name. Fantastic dancer, fantastic talent. But the movie is Royal Wedding with Fred Astaire. And this song was not nominated. There was one song that was nominated from the movie. This song is called Every Night at 7. And it's a newer arrangement of mine, and we'll see how it goes. My royal day can be a royal bore. It leaves me colder than a basement floor. The only moments I keep waiting for is when the day will be through. I never notice if it's dark or clear. What people say to me, I hardly hear. The passing hours are like an endless year until at last I'm alone with you. Every night at 7, you walk in as fresh as clover and I begin to sigh all over again. Every night at 7, you come by like May returning, and me, oh my, I start in yearning again. You seem to bring faraway spring near me. I'm always in full bloom when you're in the room. Every night at 7. Every time the same thing happens, I fall once again in love, but only with you. Thanks everybody for the opportunity, and we'll see you next time. And if you want us to get these song sheets, ukesterbrown.com. I have all the songs that I play and perform on there free of charge for the song sheets. So check out ukesterbrown.com.
David, you can go one more. Encore.
I even put in a shameless plug for my website. Well, let's do this one then. This is another one. The weather is frightening. The thunder and lightning seem to be having their way. But as far as I'm concerned, it's a lovely day. Turning the weather will keep us together. So I can honestly say that as far as I'm concerned, it's a lovely day. And everything's okay. Isn't it a lovely day to be caught in the rain? You were going on your way, now you've got to remain. Just as you were going, leaving me all at sea, the clouds broke, they broke, and oh, what a break for me. I can see the sun up high, though we're caught in a storm. I can see where you and I could be cozy and warm. Let the rain pitter patter, cause it really doesn't matter. The skies are gray, long as I can be with you, it's a lovely day. For me, I can see the sun up high, though we're caught in a storm. I can see where you and I could be cozy and warm. Let the rain pitter patter, cause it really doesn't matter if the skies are gray. Long as I can be with you, it's a lovely day. Let the rain pitter patter, cause it really doesn't matter if the skies are gray. Long as I can be with you, it's a lovely day. Thanks again, everybody. Hope you have a great rest of the day, and we'll see you next time.
Thank you again, David.
Here, thanks for the invitation.
So our last performer today is from Barcelona, Spain. His name is Choan Galvez. I think I'm pronouncing it correctly. And we've heard a song that he composed on a separate week. The performer was Giovanni Albini, and he mentioned Choan about this beautiful song that you arranged. And I wasn't thinking that you would contact me eventually and say, can I be on your show?
Thank you for being here.
You're making this all the more an award-winning show. A great show. We're so glad that that you're able to do this. And we're looking forward to hearing you perform. Thank you very much.
Thank you for the invitation. Now I have a novelty because I have some movie music for movies that haven't happened yet. So you have to picture your own movie while I'm playing. When I started playing the ukulele, I was attracted by the arrangements by John King. And among the things that he did was playing some Irish music that James Hill was doing at the moment too. So I was hooked by the campanella thing immediately. I started arranging in Celtic tunes, and years later I started writing my own tunes, and among them some Celtic stuff. So I'm going to play a set of two. The first is a kind of sleep gig, It's called The Whale. The second one is Left Hand Reel. Hope you like it. Interest started writing seriously for the ukulele when my wife and me were expecting a baby. So I started writing a bunch of lullabies, and some of them have been materialized in my CDs and books, such as this one. This is lullabies for astronauts, my second CD and book. I'm gonna play the opening tune. That's Nana para Greta. Lullaby for Greta. I kind of pictured a dream of a little lady among clouds of cotton, and that's my picture. Now, second lullaby, this is Dream Big, Little Monster from my upcoming album. It is not published yet, but it's becoming very soon. Thank you. Now for our, thank you. Now for our new rabbi, this is Canción para Eris, Song for Eris from my first album, 10 minutos para ukulele solo. Among the things that I do, I teach ukulele for the benefit of my students and of course for my own learning. I wrote a bunch of ukulele studies, a bunch of 50 short pieces called 50 miniature studies for ukulele. These are 50 pieces for around 1 minute each, and they'll become compiled in a book that's going to be published next week. So if you want to look for it, all my discography is available from Bandcamp. If you look for Choan Galvez in Bandcamp, you'll find me. And so I'm going to play, if we have the time, 4 of these pieces, 4 minutes. The first one is Tenderness. Second one's Idealized. So this is the number one, Tenderness. One of the things that I wanted to do with this set of studies was, apart from using to teach and to learn on my own, try to challenge me to do different things when composing. So this one that I'm going to play now, the challenge I chose was to to make a piece to play with just one letter. So this is R on the C string. This last one was broken, a piece which connects measures of 5/8 with the four. It has a kind of broken feeling. So I don't know if we have time, organization. So, another thing I like to do is write sad songs for ukulele. So the ukulele may be by default a happy instrument, but we are not always happy people. So as I find the ukulele is my tool for expression, I sometimes write happy music occasionally. But I also used to express grief and sadness. So this is a piece I wrote after one of my, of the family pets died. And it's a mourning for the death and a celebration of its life.
That was great.
Enjoy some music.
You really feel that emotion. It was awesome. Thank you so much, Choan.
Thank you.
That was a beautiful arrangement. Kind of stark, but you know, just the feeling was so, it was so appropriate. Having that you lost someone that you loved, that was great. I asked another artist if she would be willing to play one more song. I haven't seen her response, but Aline Kelly, are you still here? Would you be willing to play one more song? I'm not hearing from her.
She might not be by her house.
All right. Well, that's fine. Marc, do you want to take us out?
Yeah, come on, Marc. Yeah.
Sure.
Thank you, Marc, for being co-host today.
Marc, it's been awesome today. We learned so much about the Oscars.
It's been my absolute pleasure to co-host for you today. I wasn't expecting this, so I'm just kind of curious as to what sort of music are we feeling in terms of like songs from films?
Well, play something happy.
Something happy. Okay, got to try to think of an idea or so. Let's grab this little bugger. Something happy. This one is less from film, but more from television, especially if you are into British comedy. This is a song made famous. I don't know if it was written by, but it was made famous by Marc Gallagher. It's called Bring Me Sunshine. Can't get more happy than that, can we? Bring me sunshine in your smile, bring me laughter all the while. In this world where we live, there should be more happiness. So much joy you can give to each brand new bright tomorrow. Make me happy through the years. Never bring me any tears. Let your arms be as warm as the sun from up above. Bring me fun, bring me sunshine, bring me love. Bring me sunshine in your eyes, bring me rainbows from the skies. Life's too short to be spent having anything but fun. We can be so content if we gather little sermons, be light-hearted all day long. Keep me singing those happy songs. Let your arms be as warm as the sun from up above. Bring me fun, bring me sunshine, bring me love. Bring me fun, bring me sunshine, bring me love. Bring me fun, bring me sunshine, bring me love.
Thank you, Marc Gallagher.
Okay, and then, yes.
All right. So we'd like to thank Vlastimil Prochaska for accepting his award and also performing some great movie songs. And Calico, man, that duo, every time I hear them, they get better. And they look fabulous.
They look fabulous. They look like us, for sure. Look at Keith's
tie. They could actually walk down the red carpet.
That's right.
Wendy Matthews, thank you so much.
Oh, classic,
So, and Ukester Brown, thank you so much for coming today. It's good to have you back, and just loved your performance, the songs you chose. We asked Aline Kelly to, if she'd be willing to play one more song for us.
And she's setting up.
She's setting up right now, but also while she's setting up, want to thank again, kind of a special guest, Choan Galvez. Great performance. And the story behind that is I messed up on the schedule and I had another performer from Boston to perform again this week, and she emailed me and said, Keith, I'm not on this week. So and then Choan, like within hours, happened to email me. It was so wonderful. So anyway, what we're gonna do is basically Aline Kelly is gonna kick off our Canicopilo. We start the Canicopilo around 4 o'clock when the show is over, and anyone can perform.